Previously on Big Brother, after enduring a lengthy competition, Anna became the new HOC and nominated Marjane and Felicia. The students face off in a Big Brother classic and were asked to bring answers back to Otev's cousin, Albob. Natasha won the veto and was forced to make a huge decision. Meanwhile, the hunt was on for the final secret of Scholastica. Andrea found the secret and was awarded the power of the Big Brother vote. At the veto ceremony, Natasha chose not to use the power of veto. Who will be expelled from the Big Brother class? And who will guarantee themselves a spot in the final four? Find out now on Big Brother.
I was super happy that Natasha did not use the power of veto, and I also was not very surprised because, like I said, like I wasn't expecting her to, because I don't think it would have been good for her game, because then it would kind of be like, oh, well, what are you doing here? Are you working with this person? Or so.
I want to break up Marjane and Felicia because if they make it further, they're obviously going to take each other in the end, which isn't good for my game, so that's just going to be my reason.
I was fine with that. Excuse me, I was fine with seeing Marjane and Felicia out there because I know for sure that one of them is obviously going home now. I do feel bad because they're my friends outside of the game and inside the game, but at the end of the day, it is a game. One of us is going to go home, and if it's those two against, it's the final three with those two, then the other person's for sure out because they're just going to gang up on that other person. So, yeah, I was fine with them being up there, so.
Basically, me and Felicia were just like, let the best person win. I'm not gonna like feel bad if one person stays and the other one doesn't. So I talked to Andrea last night and I just straight up told her like, can I have your vote? She's like, yeah, I like you more than Felicia. Like, I would rather have you win than her.
After the veto, Marjane was just wondering like if she could have my vote. I'm like, yeah. Like, I don't want you to go. I want Felicia gone. Like, even if the other people vote you out, I'm still voting out Felicia, so you're good.
You're right, we're the real dynamic duo. Just my one Taylor were fake.
They weren't even close. It was so funny.
Oh my god, I think I've said this like in all my fight games. Like, Felicia, you suck.
I do. That's the truth, too.
I think I've said this in all like my diary rooms. Like, Felicia sucks. I wish she like pulls out a win finally. I'm just like, she can't win a competition. She's like,
can't.
I think I said that to Andrea, too. Because I say that all the time. Like, Felicia just sucks. No, look, because she was talking about, the back and forth one with the police. I'm like, yeah, it was like Anthony, then Jesse, and then like Anna, Tosh, and Andrea. Then there was Felicia. It's fine though.
It's okay.
We all suck.
I
sometimes.
Tried.
No, I'm pretty sure I sucked in the last HOC comp. So.
I sucked at everything. So I mean, I found the name. I'm just like, I don't know how to spell Veronica. I'm trying to find the V. No, she throws other shade. I'm like, dude. Sometimes I wonder why she throws so much shade. Like, sometimes, like, why do you throw shade at, like, some people who could be HOC and, like, could put you up on the fucking block? Like, Anna, do you not see because she only has Puzzle as her friend? You're up on the damn block now.
No, that's not because of, that's not the reason why.
I know, but I'm giving an example. Because we're talking about Puzzle.
I'm just saying, like, live your life to the fullest. And if I'm going to talk about somebody, I'm not going to care. That's all I'm saying.
I don't throw a lot of shade. It's gonna suck.
Yeah, no one's gonna understand my jokes as much as Felicia.
I think I'm the only person really understood the jokes.
No one's gonna be able to tell Felicia to shut up when I like how I do. Like, I tell you to shut up all the time.
Do I talk a lot?
Sometimes you annoy me.
There's parts where I get on tangents. I made a bunch of noise while we were waiting, and she was like, "Please just shut up." And I was like, "No." And I was like,
"I'm pretty sure I know you sometimes. So it's fine."
Yeah, don't worry. I'm a little sibling. It's fine.
Good luck.
Yeah.
And plus, I'm gonna make my last speech very emotional.
Are you gonna cry?
No.
Are you gonna like throw shit?
Yeah, I'm gonna
throw shade. Throw the shade at everyone. If you walk out, I don't know who's gonna like walk out. You better throw shade at every single little person. You're like,
if I walk out, I'm not giving no one a hug. Don't say bye to me. Oh, I'll give you a hug. I mean, but don't say bye to me. Don't try to give me a hug. Don't act like you just ain't till my death certificate, basically. Don't be fake.
It's hard, and I don't want to go against her, but I mean, I want to stay in the game. Like, we were talking about, like, who wants to, like, forfeit, and I'm like, I don't want to forfeit. She doesn't want to forfeit. We both love this game, and, like, I am to the point where I want to fight for my vote. Like, she gave me this look. I don't, like, this look. Like, you know, like, little siblings give, like, they like, and, like, you should give it to me, you know? Like, but, like, she didn't, I don't know how to do this look, because I didn't master it yet. I will never master this look, like this puppy dog look. And they're like, you know, you should give it to me, Ray. And I'm like, because she's the youngest and I'm the oldest. So I'm like, I can like see signals of like little siblings coming out. Because I mean, I have a sister who's 9 and I love her. She's so cute. But she like gives this look and then like the tilts of the head. And like, you should like, I want to stay in this game. Like, no kidding. I want to stay in this game too. I know you want to stay in this game, but I want to stay in the game too. So I was like, I want to fight for my votes. Like, I already know you have energy, so I have to get these 2 votes to stay in. And I don't know how it feels with you, but like Tasha Rave told me she wants to keep me in, so I just have to keep Anthony's vote to make sure that he stays with me.
Okay. Well, I talked to Felicia right after Vito, and after it didn't get used, obviously Felicia wanted to stay, obviously Marjane wanted to stay. Obviously I can't keep them both. Yeah.
So, first of all, I apologize that I'm like a little happy that you didn't use it, obviously.
Mm-hmm. You would have been up. Mm-hmm. Now you have to vote between Marjane and I.
Which is not fun at all.
Mm-mm. That's not fun. I already know she has 1 vote already.
Who?
Andrea. Of course. Yeah. Andrea's not going to keep me. Even if I talk to her, she's not going to keep me. She wants me gone. And I don't understand why, because basically, well, she sees that she can use Marjane more than me, of course. And I feel like if you were to keep me over her, Andrea would work with her more than you. If that makes any sense.
Mm-hmm.
And you should do what's best in your interest and not. Because at this point, the final 4 that we created
is dead.
Is dead. The final 3 that we created is dead.
It's probably not gonna work either, you know.
Yeah, I had a conversation with Anthony last night and like pulled him aside first so I could get into his head before Marjane could, because I know she pulled Andrew, and I pulled Anthony first because I want to make sure that I got like to talk to him before anyone else, because I mean, he's my closest ally, because Marjorie's gonna leave, so he's my second closest ally, and now he's gonna be my best friend for now. So I mean, I approached him telling him that like where my game's at, and like I can't, of course, like the strategy and everything about like the final 3 is broken up, final 4 is broken up, that like if Marjane stays, she can work with Andrea and she can backdoor you, of course, and I'm Andrea's target too, so if you keep me, the target on your back is smaller, you know?
Okay, but yeah, you should do what's best in your interest, and I feel like, I mean, I'm not trying to push it, but I feel like you would get farther with me because Andrea would have, like, her target's you, of course,
mm-hmm.
but and me. That's not gonna be Marjane. So if she won HOC, she's gonna put me and you up, and she'd probably get me out more than you.
Yeah.
Instead of Marjane. She's going to keep Marjane until the end. And then backdoor her.
That's a good point.
I feel so bad throwing my friend on the bus. I have never felt so bad. I feel so guilty.
But you're not throwing her under the bus in terms of, like, trying to, like...
Shade.
Yeah, exactly. Like, you're not throwing shade on her. You're just saying, you know, that this makes more sense than... Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't think... Even when she watches this, she'll think that that's the case.
Yeah. Yeah. And then you have a higher chance of winning HOC anyways, because I suck at every competition. I don't win. I can't do anything. I get out first. And I mean... this is going to be a struggle on you, because you don't know what you're going to do.
I don't know. Like, this is... such... not fun. I don't know. I was just, like, kind of hoping that maybe we could just all meet and, like, talk about it and figure out what we all wanted to do, but I mean, I know you both really want to stay in this game, so I don't think
we tried talking that out. That's not going to work out.
Really?
You are going to have to make the decision.
It's so stupid. Like, this secret's actually just as powerful as the diamond. Just as powerful as the diamond power of Vito, just because what happened last week is exactly what gets to happen this week if they win Vito again. Or next week if they win Vito again.
And then basically you're screwed up.
And then I heard you guys were there, and you guys kind of brought her there, and then she found it.
More or less.
So she used you. Is it like the diamond? Can we talk about the diamond now? So basically Anna fucking used me.
Really?
She used me to find the Vito.
Really?
Yeah, I cracked down every single code, and she used me. And now Andrew used you, and I'm fucking pissed.
We're losing this game because of technicality. Not really technicalities.
Yeah, I found it, put all the clues together, and she's like, oh, here it is.
Yeah.
I would have been in this predicament. We could have made, like...
you know, Anna could just be gone right now.
Mm-hmm.
Those would be great. Whatever. Like, I actually almost want Anna gone more than Andrea right now.
I want them both gone.
I know.
I'm just
double expulsion next week, please.
We do.
Four for more.
I want to keep Felicia because I don't agree with something that Marjane did, but like I was worried how it would affect my game because then it would prove that like I was working with her. Marjane like told me when I had the veto that she talked to Felicia and they decided together that Marjane would continue on playing. And I talked to Felicia and she's like, no, that is not what was said. Felicia figured she would be going home because she thought she was a bigger target. But Marjane, I think, told me and maybe one other that like they decided as friends, like the twins thing, like Marjane was gonna continue on. And that's not what Felicia said, so it bothers me that she would do that to her friend. So.
This is the hardest thing that's had to happen in this game for me, other than when I had zero time to think about what to do when Ronnie was up on the block. Yeah, this was a hard decision.
I was like super emotional yesterday. I don't know. I'm like, Felicia, I just feel bad because I can't like rally against you and be, oh, you should pick me over Felicia because of blah, blah, blah. And I just feel, I just want her to stay. I want both of us to stay. But yeah. Odds are probably won't happen.
I feel like Natasha gets along with Felicia better, so I feel like she might vote to keep Felicia. And obviously, I'm gonna vote to keep Marjane. So it comes down to Anthony and what he wants to do. If he wants me to trust him more, like if he truly wants me to trust him, I think he'll end up voting out Felicia. So that will be good for me, but I'm not completely sure what he'll do.
At this point, I'm fine with either of them going. I would rather see Marjane stay, not because I enjoy her singing in the game, even though it's very lovely, Marjane. It's just that I feel Felicia's more competitive and she'd have a greater chance of winning something. So, I mean, it sounds bad, but at the end of the day, it's nicer to have Marjane there knowing that she's not much of a competition, you know, towards me for this game, so it would just, I don't know, I feel like it'd be nicer to have her there.
Alright, so before we get to the vote, I just want to tell you all that this week is a different type of week than normal for Big Brother. Week 8 is going to be Big Brother Speed Week. So from this point to next Sunday, starting right now, we're going to have 3 expulsions. So by the time you leave for Thanksgiving break, we'll be down to the final 3. Okay, so that means instead of doing one thing a night, we'll be doing 2 things. So you're going to have to strategize far in advance. You won't have a lot of time to plan stuff. So the way, like how it will work is we'll have an expulsion today, and we'll have the head of class competition. Tomorrow we'll have nominations, and immediately following, we'll have the power veto competition. Tuesday, we will have the veto ceremony, expulsion, and the next head of class competition. Wednesday will be nominations again and the veto competition, and then Thursday will be the veto ceremony and expulsion. So by Thursday, we'll be down to the final three.
Everything was rushing through my mind. I was like, oh my god, this week's gonna be really crazy. Like, I don't know how this competition's gonna go for this week, but it's definitely really exciting.
Jake says that it's speed week, and I was like, well, I wasn't too shocked because that stuff happens all the time in Big Brother, expect the unexpected, but it's like, whoa, like, a lot's going to be happening really fast, obviously. So, it's exciting, but also makes me a little nervous.
Well, the number just keeps getting smaller and smaller, and I'm still amazed I'm here, so it'll be really interesting to see what happens at the end of the week, and it's a lot to, like, comprehend.
Big Brother speed week. I thought like next week where it was just going to go really quick, like boom, 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 3 days, somebody's gone. But I guess we're doing it this week. Gosh, it's getting really real right now. There's going to be 3 people left in 3 days, like 2 days, I don't know. Really, really soon. It's going to be pretty intense.
So now we'll get to the vote. So Marjane and Felicia are on the block, so each of them will have a chance to say why you should vote to keep them. So Marjane, you can go first.
You should vote to keep me, because I'm funny. Who can make you laugh like that? See? No hard feelings if you don't. Pretty good game.
Well, I'm on the block. Thanks, Marjane. I'd be grateful if you guys kept me. I enjoy playing this game, and shout out to Tosh. Happy 18th birthday. hope you guys keep me in the city for this week.
Alright, so one at a time, you'll go vote. Everyone will vote except for Anna, who's the current head of class. So, Natasha, you can.
I vote to expel Marjane.
Well, I know everyone's probably voting the opposite way, but I vote to expel Felicia because I don't like her.
Is there a third option this week? I vote to expel Marjane from the class.
Alright, so
when
I reveal the vote, the expelled student will just have a few minutes to say goodbye and leave through the classroom door. By a vote of 2-1, Marjane, you've been expelled from Big Brother class.
Of course.
And holding her hand, it was just kind of sucked because she, like, sitting there, she had a talk with Anthony beforehand, and she knew already that she was going. And she was, like, crying, and she was like, it was like, you have the biggest storm out ever. And she didn't really have the biggest storm out.
I don't know. I guess it didn't really bother me, like, game-wise. But, as a friend, it was sad to see her go.
It's a bummer to see Marjane go. She's the one that keeps everyone laughing. So, might be a little more boring going into the next weeks.
It's my birthday, happy.
I don't know. And Marjane was a lot more pissed than I thought she'd be.
Bye.
I'm thinking, alright, I talked to Andrea beforehand. She sounded like she might not even want to win right now, which obviously is kind of a little bit in my, you know, good interest to make it through this week. But at the same time, I don't want to win either, like, because next week then I can, you know, I'd have a chance to both win HOC to ensure that I make the final three, or win veto, so I have two chances to secure making final three. If I win this week, that means that all I can do to ensure my own safety is win veto next week, which, you know, that's one chance to save myself is not as good as two next week.
Ideally would probably be Andrea at this point, which is still so weird to say that Andrea and I are on the same. Are on the same side, but hey, I mean, that's how the game works. Surprises are always happening. So yeah, I would definitely love to see Andrea win this, if not Natasha too, since it will be her birthday Sunday. So that'd be really cool if Natasha got to gets to win on her birthday.
Okay, so this HOC competition is called the Domino Rally, and here's how it's going to work. Your goal is to stack a line of dominoes across the table so that when you push one, it creates a chain reaction, knocking all of the dominoes down. You have to start on this side behind the blue line. The domino cannot be touching the blue line with the first one you place. And it has to go across the table so that when you push it, the last domino falls off the table. You have to use all of your dominoes. The first person to do so will win the title of HOC. Here's the catch though. You have to keep one hand behind your back at all times. So you only get one hand to do this with. When you are ready to push, you need to call me over, because if you do not call me over and I give you the okay go, it won't count. So make sure you call me over and I say go before you push your first domino. All right. So on your mark, get set, go. One hand stays behind your back at all times. You may not switch hands either. The hand you're using is the hand you have to keep working with.
What? I just tried to like have everything spaced out pretty evenly. That's why I kind of went and put them how I did, set them down how I did.
So my strategy was to like have my thumb on my jean loop. I don't know what you want to call it, belt loop, whatever. That thing, that loopy thing that you like put your like belt through. So I like for sure like held my hand there, so I would only use one hand.
Natasha knocks some of hers over.
I feel like the HOC was a mutual, we're all trying to throw it, but like get close enough to the point where like if someone we didn't want to win was going to, that we could like, you know, do it. So I get them set up really quickly and I was like, oh shit, you know what, these people are really dramatically throwing it.
I got it straight, like first like 10 went and it didn't go and I was like shaking. And then the second one, it didn't go, it went farther, but it didn't go all the way. And I was like, fuck, I gotta fix this. And I was like, God.
When people started saying, asking if they could go, I was like, I need to get moving.
Felicia does not make it. Natasha, you can go. Andrew doesn't quite make it.
Are you shitting me? Felicia tries, and I'm like, oh, because Anthony told me we couldn't throw it to Felicia because, like, it depends on the veto. And if one of the nominees gets taken down, we'd be going up. One of us would, so. I was like, oh damn, okay, try it.
This competition was so crucial. It was like, Adrian cannot win. It was either Anthony, Natasha, or I. Like, we had to like line it up, like, we had to go for it. Like,
okay, this is a lot harder than I thought it was gonna be. Like, I thought it'd just go down the first time, but it didn't. So, like, start setting it up again.
Oh no.
Jake, I'm ready.
Go. There you go.
Right. Made it through it. And I won! Oh my god. I can't win next week, but I'm still pretty excited. I have Final Four on lock. Okay. That's pretty exciting. Yeah. Mixed feelings about it right now, but it felt pretty good to just have this week on lock.
I'm glad Anthony won, because then I don't have to do anything. And I can just sit pretty, and I know I should be good this week. And then I can fight for HOC next week, which is what everyone is concerned about at this point. It's like, I don't care if I get nominated this week, I need to play next week. That's like everyone's mindset. So like, I've never thrown a competition before, but that one I would say I probably threw it.
It's a sigh of relief. It was like, I already knew he was going for the same targets. I know he talked to me, I was like solidifying. I was like, it's me and Tosh. But all I have to worry about is like, is he gonna betray me? Like, because, you know, this game, you can't always trust people, so I was like...
Anthony will have to make his selections for nomination.
When Anthony's goes all the way down and one falls off the table and he wins, I was like, well, I know Andrea and I are going up. One, because Andrea has the secret, and two, just because Andrea and I are a threat right now to Anthony, because he knows that we don't want him in this game anymore. Plus, like, last week he told me he didn't trust me at all, so I already knew I was going up.
Well, when Anthony wins, I'm pretty sure me and Anna are going to go up on the block. And I mean, I felt like that with anyone besides me winning, really, that could happen. I mean, maybe Natasha wouldn't put me up, but anyone else, her, like Felicia or Anthony, I knew would put up me and Anna. So, I mean, it's kind of a bummer, but like I said, I'm pretty sure I'm safe this week. So, I mean, that's kind of good for me.
But at this point, I mean, I'm worried that if one of them win veto, if I put them up, They're gonna take each one of them down, and then they'll be able to have the secret. And so if Andrea wins veto, she takes herself down. There's only two people voting, so she'll vote, and then she'll use the secret to cast an additional vote, so it'll be 2-1 and I'll stay. So like, that's my main concern.
Alright.
I wasn't even sure I wanted to win this one.
Yeah, I'm saying because I want to be able to win the next one. Just because then I won't have to worry about winning veto then, but
You're right.
The whole vote thing, obviously, I'm probably gonna end up having to talk to like Natasha and stuff too, because I'm not gonna
talk with everyone. Okay,
like, yeah,
she didn't like come out right away and like say, oh, I want Felicia to stay. Like, she was just kind of up in the air, like, oh, what are you gonna do? I told her to talk to Andrea and like said that you're probably not gonna keep Marjanae, but I'm thinking that I would rather. Or I mean, sorry, that you were thinking about keeping Marjanae, or would you rather see that?
Mm-hmm.
Like, for me, that I wouldn't really want to see her, and then I just kind of, like, left it to her, and she was like, so maybe she just, like, went along with it at that point. She was like, oh, good, Felicia's gonna stay, like, because mm-hmm. then she gets to break the vote, but...
I mean, I understand if what you do is, like, put us up, because, like, that makes sense, but then there's also gonna be veto, and then
yeah,
can change things.
Right, so, like, it's like, if I put both of you up, and, like, one of you wins veto, and then stay safe, and then the secret gets used for you both to be safe. It's exactly what happened for me 2 weeks ago.
mm-hmm.
but at the same time, like, if I don't put both of you up, either way, both of you would stay, and like, there's no chance of me getting Anna out then. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
But at the same time, I don't, like, if I use it, I feel like I'm gonna make everyone mad. Like, if I use it on here.
But, so would you be interested in doing, like, what I mentioned about not being able to use it at all?
Yeah, I don't know.
Because that's like the only way that like that I for sure, like honestly, I will put Felicia up next to Anna if you give it to me and I can just like burn it.
So Anthony did tell me he's probably gonna put up me and Anna, and I'm not shocked, and I mean, I'm not as mad as I was last time because it makes more sense to me, obviously, than the first time he put me on the block. It was kind of like being stabbed in the back, whereas this time it's like, I have this secret. I'm probably gonna use it, like.
You know, like.
And then
you didn't do anything wrong,
voting.
So I wouldn't like be upset. And then it would be Anna keeping you, and then you get a break the tie, right? I'm assuming Anna's gonna vote to keep
yeah.
you. So.
Well, see, that's the reason why I wouldn't want to give you my thing, cause like.
Right, but then at the same time, like.
Just when it comes to like the veto. But,
yeah.
You know.
So how about, like, right now, like people think that I put you guys up on coming after both of you, and like I've not done anything to make it seem like we can work together, like,
yeah.
to anybody else. So, since there's, like, 100% chance that you're staying this week, even if it was you and Anna up, like,
mm-hmm.
would you agree that there's no chance that you would go home if you're up next to Anna, and
if
she wins veto?
I mean, yeah, I feel like I wouldn't go home, and I understand why you would do that,
mm-hmm.
for sure.
Like, I don't want to do it because I told you, like, last week I don't want to put you up, but
mm-hmm.
that's, like, kind of, like, the best way it could go.
It's not, like, I'm not going to be mad like I was the last
yeah,
time.
Yeah, right. not up to 10 years, like, in the driver's
seat
with the secret.
I know why you're doing it. I understand why you're doing it, whereas last time I didn't really.
Mm-hmm. Like, last time...
It was more of, like, I felt like you were stabbing me in the back, me in the back last time.
I mean, I see where he's coming from on his point, but it kind of does suck being up next to Anna again because, like, she is one of the people I like, I'm working with, and just being next to her is not fun, obviously.
Personally, I think that it will be better for me to be with you in the end than it would be for me to be with Anna or even Natasha, because thinking about it, Natasha's one less competition than Anna.
She's won. Oh, yeah, that's true. And she could easily win another one.
Yeah.
She's been a veto king.
Like, people haven't really, I feel like people haven't noticed it as much, but she has. Like,
and also she hasn't
screwed
anything.
And once everyone sits down and, like, thinks about it, yeah.
She hasn't pissed off anybody.
Like, and I feel like if it, like, so I feel like when it came down to it, if it was me sitting next to either one of them, like, I would lose. And I feel like if it was me and you, like, it'd be like a toss-up.
Yeah, it would be,
like,
really close.
I don't know.
Andrea's kind of behind it. I mean, obviously, I'm HOC, like, it's hard to tell, it's hard to gauge, like, how sincere she is with, like, agreeing with what I'm thinking. She could have just gone straight to Anna and been like, oh man, we really gotta win this week because Anthony's gonna put us both up and we can both be safe if I, like, I don't know what's actually going on there. But I know for 100% certainty that Anna's going home this week if Anna or Andrea don't win this veto. So that's huge right now. No more beer pong, please. No more beer pong, please.
It's a repeat scenario of what happened 2 weeks ago, like 100%. And then, like, it's not. It's even worse because then it's going to be Amy versus MJ next week and I can't compete in HLC. And also, I feel like Felicia feels like really comfortable that we never put her to be and that she's going to be super upset about that, so A, I'm going to lose her vote in jury, and B, she might, like, blow up her game in the process.
It's mental and physical, and every time it's that, I win. So, like,
it's true. Got this.
Should be good. I like these kind of comps. Hopefully it's good. I'm going to do everything I can.
One of us three have, like, so we have to go in guns blazing.
Well, I'm gonna win. And if I'm not gonna win, you're gonna win. If you're not gonna win, like, she's gonna win. That's the only way to look at it.
We have to.
Oh, and then going forward, like, I want you to know I have your back 100% next week.
Yeah.
Like,
I have yours too.
I will not go out without a win next week.
Well, I mean, even if you win HOC, it's like, that's not even the important part. The important part is
veto.
Because even if you win, and, like, it doesn't matter who you put up, because if one of them wins veto afterwards, they can still get it. But I don't think that, I know that Anna will hear it, but if she's gone next week, then it should be okay.
Mm-hmm.
Either way, obviously, go for HOC, get final three.
Two weeks ago, I won HOC. I put up Andrea and Anna on the block. One of them wins veto, the other one uses the secret to save the other, like, neither of them go home. This week, the exact same thing can happen. I mean, I just explained it. This would be horrible. Like, just two HOC reigns for absolutely nothing. God, that would suck so bad. I don't know.
Basically, the plan was to keep the same nominations that Anthony had up 2 weeks ago, so no blood and won't have any problems, because, I mean, if you put Tasha or I up, I'll probably be pretty pissed. Be like, why did you do that?
I'm pretty sure he'll put up Andrea and Anna, because Anna is, like, the target this week. Like, people want her out, and I 100% agree. She's just way too big of a threat. She's way too good at competitions. So she needs to go before it gets closer, because if she wins Final Four, I don't even know what the heck would happen.
This is the nomination ceremony. It's one of my duties as head of class to nominate two people for expulsion. Let's get down to it. I'm gonna pull the first key, and that person is safe. They will pull the next key. Anthony.
Anna.
Anthony, you are safe this week. Natasha, you are safe this week.
Thank you. Never stop. Felicia, you are safe.
Alright.
Oh.
I don't. This is a surprise to really anybody. It's nominations I made last time. There's no more reason for me to put, you know, make extra targets and throw enemies in this game. Nothing personal. Yeah, what else cliche can I say right now? Good luck in the veto competition, guys.
Anna is, like, competition beast. Huge threat. She's like a wild card. I don't know. She's just... like, she'll tell you one thing and you think you can believe her, but, like, she told everyone else, like, completely different things. So you don't even know what to think, so she just needs to go. Like, I need people I can rely on.
At this point, like, getting put up, it doesn't really bother me. So, like, it didn't, like, make me mad or anything. I just knew that that's how Anthony was gonna play it again, and I wasn't gonna expect anything less from him.
It sucks getting put up on the block, next to Anna, just because, like, she's the person I trust the most in the game, so obviously I don't want to see her go, and I don't want to go either, so it was a bummer, and it's happened the same exact way both times, which sucks too, but it wasn't super surprising or anything.
Because it's Speed Week, we will be playing the picking players for the veto competition today, and playing the veto competition today.
So. Oh, look, we're all picked.
So...
I want to win, but I don't want to, because it also puts a bigger threat on my back, because then I would have won, like, won 4 competitions. That's a lot of competitions, and I can't, then I'm going to turn into Anna, you know, like, everyone wants her out, because she just wins everything. Like, I don't want that to happen, but it's a very important veto to win, so that Anna can go home this week, and Andrea can use her secret to protect herself. She doesn't have the choice to use it to protect Anna.
Right now, this power veto competition tonight is, like, super important just because it's Andrew and I up against each other again. And, you know, her and I both can't afford to lose this competition because we both know that whoever else won it, it wouldn't be going to either of us. So, you know, I guess we both just have to, like, work our asses off tonight and have one of us win it.
Best case scenario, Anna wins power veto. That's what I'm hoping. That'll be me not getting any blood on my hands, her being safe, and me not having to use my power on her, me being able to use it on myself, and then nothing would really be my fault. So that would be the best case scenario for me. I mean, otherwise, if she doesn't win it, obviously I want to be the one to win it. And then I would take myself down, and I would probably use my power on Anna just because I think she could take me farther than Anthony would.
If Anna wins this veto, I am so screwed. Oh my god. It's like deja vu, just with 2 less people this week, if that happens.
Like, I was slowly, like, shaking, because I was, like, what happened yesterday with the dominoes, like, I, like, had that shaking fit again, because I was, like, I know, like, with this veto competition, it's more than ever that I have to win. Like, I don't know how safe I am with Anthony, even though he says that I'm safe under his belt, but I mean...
Welcome to the Big Brother Laboratory, where DNA studies are of the utmost importance. The Big Brother Laboratories have been using the DNA samples of the game competitors to create entirely new humans. Your goal is to identify whose DNA was used to create the human. A picture will come up on the screen that has matched the DNA of 2 students together. You must then look around the room to find the DNA samples needed to create the human. Bring them to the front desk and sit down. If you are correct, a new picture will appear. If you are incorrect, you will have to try again. This information is confidential, so you must return the DNA samples to their spots face down. When you have the correctly identified 7, when you have correctly identified 7 specimens, your time will stop. The person with the fastest time will win the power veto.
So basically, there's going to be 7 DNA mashups of 2 house guests that have competed. Doesn't matter who they are, and you have to go around. On the tables, there's everybody's name is there, face down, and you have to go and grab the 2 people who you think that this master is of.
Here we go. Ready?
Yeah.
Go.
It's the second picture. I can tell it's Taylor's face right away, and I'm thinking, who the heck is underneath Taylor's face right now? I'm like, wait, okay, yeah, oh, hey, that's my hair from a month and a half ago. Yeah, okay.
Taylor Anthony. That's correct.
All these tables are like kind of clustered together, so you gotta push your way through them and get to these names. And it was, you know, it was actually a little more difficult than I thought as far as like the obstacles that were in the room. The very last one was Aaron and Felicia, and that one was super obvious. I just like booked it. I knew exactly where Aaron's was. I knew Felicia's was kind of on the side somewhere, so I just kind of like flipped through all of them real quick. Felicia and Aaron.
That is correct. Your time is done. All right.
And I go back and buzz it in, and 7 for 7, got them all right. I'm feeling awesome at this point.
Around the room to find the DNA samples needed to create the human. Bring them back to the front desk and sit down. If you're correct, a new picture will appear. If you are incorrect, you will have to try again. This information is confidential, so you must return the DNA samples to their spots face down. When you have correctly identified 7 specimens, your time will stop. Person with the fastest time will win the power of Ito.
Like, no offense, I was like, damn, I didn't know this was like high tech enough to do this one. I was like, oh great.
On your mark, get set, go. Alright, yeah, come, you can stand on this side. If you want a chair.
Well, it's obviously Michael's face, but the hair threw me off. I was like, whose hair is that? Like, because I don't remember how people styled their hair. And then I was like, looked at the shirt, and I'm like, oh, it's Lindsay.
She wants to put him down, fail out of the shows.
Wait, what is it?
Fail out of the shooting to show.
Lindsay Michael.
That's correct.
Can I come back?
Yep.
And it was hard for me to remember where I saw names. So, like, it was hard for me to find which one is where. to go as fast as I could. And for some reason, I thought we had to come to the front for each thing. So, like, I put the names back, ran, so.
See you later, Cole.
That's correct.
I recognized my shirt before anything. And then I was like, oh, that's my hair, too. And then I just recognized her face. And I couldn't even find my name. I couldn't find my name, and I could never find Anna's name, so.
Oh, that's me. Where was that bitch again?
Welcome to the Big Brother Laboratory, where DNA studies are of the utmost importance.
I was super excited because I knew it was like, you know, two different faces put together and you had to go run and, you know, grab the two names that the faces were made up of. So I was super excited for it, but I was also really nervous.
Here we go. And your time is going.
Okay, so Michael and Lindsay's picture was really funny because it was like Lindsay's body and hair and then it was like basically Michael's face, and that was one of the funniest actually of them all. Body, but the eyes, the nose seemed really, I guess it seemed larger than usual, so that made me think it was like a male's nose, like, you know, Anthony or Taylor or something.
Is it Aaron and Cole?
That is incorrect.
Oh, God damn it. This is so hard.
But then the eyes were obviously females because they were eyeliner, but for some reason I kept running back and grabbing two guys' names and I just don't know why I kept doing that.
Is it Aaron and Anthony?
That is incorrect.
Oh my goodness. Aaron and Michael?
That is incorrect.
Oh. Is it Aaron and Natasha?
That is incorrect.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh God, I'm gonna lose this competition. This is so bad. I'm just gonna go down the line. Is it Aaron and Veronica?
That is incorrect.
Yep. Okay. Aaron and Andrea?
That is correct.
Oh my God, that took forever.
I was doing really good up until the third one, which was Aaron and Andrea, and that really pissed me off because that took me like 3 minutes alone just to figure it out. I literally did almost everybody's goddamn name, and that sent me back really bad, and that, yeah, that really pissed me off actually because I just could not figure it out for some reason.
Oh, that one's fun. Where the hell am I? Oh, I'm over here.
is correct.
Yeah, not gonna lie, her and I combined, we look pretty good. I mean, if it was possible for both of us to have kids together, they'd be good looking.
No, she wasn't right here. No. Give me a break. Annie, Felicia?
That's correct. Your time has stopped.
I already knew my time was shit, honestly, because that third one, if I didn't have that third one, like, since there was 10 options and only seven of them were played, if I had a different one, I definitely would have been a lot faster than I was, and that's what really set me back, and that's what, it just really pisses me off, honestly.
When I walked in to the veto and I saw the screen, I was like, yep, it's like the exact competition I thought was going to be coming, which was the one where they mix the faces together. So I was excited because that's one I wanted to see happen.
Go.
Oh my god! Okay, so the first picture was probably my favorite of Michael and Lindsay because it like combined like, it combined it so well. Like, it looked real, but it was just awful, like, at the same time. So it was so funny, and I think that probably took up a little bit of my time, too, because I had to, like, sit there for a second and just laugh at it, because it was so funny.
So you grab the blue pieces of paper, that's the name of the line.
Me and Aaron, I knew it was Aaron right away, but I couldn't even tell it was me right away, but, like, I got it, like, on the first try, but, like, I didn't know, like, who it was at first, and it was me, so I thought that was funny. I didn't really have a strategy, I just wanted to find the right people and get them there. I felt like I went pretty slow, and I could never, like, remember where I saw the names, so I kept looking in the same spots, like, over and over. I think that's probably what took up some of my time.
Wait, Sean, man.
That's correct. You're done.
When I left the room, I felt like I did it pretty fast. Like, I didn't feel like I was in there for too long, so I felt pretty good about it. And just because of how long I was waiting out there, I felt like I took less time.
On your mark, get set, go.
Oh!
failing IQ.
That's correct.
Speed up time when I got my answer correct, grabbed the names, put them back, turned around, and was like that person, and went for it. So.
That's correct.
If they have kids, they're gonna have little kids, and I would love to help you give birth. Pretty good. I mean, I think I put my best foot forward. Surprisingly, I was like, I didn't have any confusions. Everything was right. I felt like I ran. I don't know how everyone else did, but I know I did decent.
Okay, here are the results of the Big Brother DNA Match. So Andrea had a time of 3 minutes and 54 seconds. Yes.
Like, I felt like that was a pretty fast time, so I thought it was pretty good. And then like everyone else was like, ooh, and I was like, maybe I won. So I felt good about it.
At that point I was like, well, maybe, you know, my time isn't that bad. Like, maybe it's close to 3 or 4 minutes. So I wasn't, you know, I wasn't too worried about hers.
Her time was 3 minutes and 54 seconds, and I'm thinking that seems like a really good time, but I think I have a better time than that.
All right.
That's a good longer.
Anthony had a time of 2 minutes and 53 seconds.
Oh my shit!
Yeah, you guys were
right. Oh,
2 minutes and 54 seconds, and I'm just feeling like on top of the world right now. I'm still nervous. Like, obviously, Anna could have had a good time, but she was saying at that point, like, when Andrea had her time, and I was like, holy crap, I feel like I did so bad, something, something. So I'm kind of feeling good about that.
See, I expected my time to be like 5 minutes, so I was like, damn, I am screwed. And then somehow Anthony pulls out like 2 minutes and whatever, and I was like, okay, he's gonna win, that's fine.
So, pretty sure you had the best time, so that's a good job.
4 minutes! Oh my god, I told you!
I was curious.
25 seconds.
I don't want to see mine!
Oh my god, I was so mad when I saw mine. It was like 6.5 goddamn minutes. Like, oh, like, I'm kind of mad at Jake for the third picture, because if I had any other picture, I would have been fine, because I was running pretty fast. I'm so damn pissed. I'm still so mad at that time, because I'm not bad at these competitions, and the one fucking competition I need to, like, save my ass, and I just blow it. I just blew it, and I'm oh, that's how I still feel. I'm never going to let this down. I'm going to be so mad at myself forever.
Oh my god, it was like 6 minutes, and I was like, dude, I thought she did faster, like, did a lot faster than, like, that time, because I was like...
So. When I saw Anna's time, I was really mad. I'm like, come on, girl, you're supposed to be good at puzzles, this is like a puzzle. Like, I was bummed out, obviously, at that point, like, we're staying on the block.
The feeling that I got right there was like, just, I don't even know. I was so excited. I am so excited right now. Because, I mean, Anna's going home for sure at this point. Doesn't matter. And I feel like, okay, good. And I also have a veto to add on to my list of wins, right?
So bad.
Natasha had a time.
You got this.
No.
Of 3 minutes and 26 seconds.
Oh, good lord.
So Felicia needs a time faster than 2 minutes and 53 seconds.
Because how long he took to get back.
So Felicia had a time of 2 minutes and
36
seconds. Nice.
And then Felicia had the best time, and I was really shocked. I'm like maybe she can win a competition.
So Felicia, her time gets revealed, and it's 2 minutes and 36 seconds. She's got me beat by over 20 seconds. I'm just thinking, holy crap.
So yeah, you guys were cruising through this. I was here, but I said,
were you like waiting? Yeah.
I fucking won. I was like, that's a lot of effings. Sorry, my bad. I was so happy.
I was like doing my dance. You guys see my safety shirt on the back. Like, this is my favorite shirt I got.
Thank you, Mr. Vaughn. Like I was on robotics team. I was like really nerdy, and I was like the safety captain and everything. And I was like, yes, I actually won a competition. It was a veto, and it wasn't like punishments. Like, I didn't have to go upstairs and wear a stupid shirt. Or what else did I do? I'm just happy.
And Felicia has the power of veto, so tomorrow she can decide to either take Andrea or Anna off the block, and then right following that we'll have the expulsion, and then following that we'll have the next HLC competition that will not be physical in any way, shape, or form. So
nice.
That's what you have coming up tomorrow, and we'll meet at 10:30. Interviews tomorrow, so check your times. If something doesn't work, let me know. And yeah, so.
The veto needs to not be used, or else I'm screwed. And I don't know, like, Anna needs to go home. And then I need to win HOC.
With Andrea having the secret, I just know for sure I'm going home. And I'm so mad at myself. Like, I blame myself more than anything for that competition.
I'm pretty excited that everything worked out this week, finally. I mean, it worked out really well last week, too. Natasha won veto. Neither of us could have gone home last week. But yeah, things are starting to fall into place a little better.
Obviously, Felicia winning the power of veto keeps me on the block, keeps Anna on the block. The noms are going to stay the same for sure. Like, I couldn't doubt. I would probably drop dead if she used it because I'd be so surprised. And I mean, even if she did use it, it wouldn't really matter. It would suck no matter what, because if she did use it, Natasha would be up and she's like another person that I'm kind of close with. So, no matter what, it's not good for anyone, but I feel like if Natasha were to win it or Anthony were to win it, I'd still be in the same situation. The only thing that would have been good if I won it or Anna won it, so.
So I was just like, I have to win and hopefully keep my rise up and always play like it's my last day, because now you can't play safe. Like, I felt like I was kind of like riding coaster, and now I just want to shoot up. That's all my goal is, like, pull Steve and a Derek. Steve Derek. Plus to Derek.
Will Felicia use the power of veto to save either Andrea or Anna from the block? If so, who will be named the replacement? Who will leave the class? And who will become the new HOC? Find out next time on Big Brother, Secrets of Scholastica.